Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and I am really glad that you joined me today. We're going to make some camp furniture. I'm going to show you how to make some camp furniture, and I'm going to show you how to make a handy tool that will really help in making that camp furniture. So, let's get started. Okay, as I said in the intro, there's a cool tool that I've wanted for a long time, but they're kind of hard to get and they're expensive. So I decided to make one. Let me show you how I made it. It's called a Scotch Eyed Auger is the common name for it. Okay. What I did was I used common plumbing fitting. Okay. Right there, it's a half inch. You can see here, it's a half inch plumbing fitting, and I got a cap for it. Okay. It's also a half inch black plug, it's called. It's a plug for it. Okay, to make this, I took a straight edge and I laid it across the top of the plug. And I marked it from one corner to the other, and then I laid it 90 degrees to that line, and I marked it again from one corner to the other corner. Okay, where those lines intersected, right in the middle, I drilled a small hole, a pilot hole. Then once I had that pilot hole drilled, I drilled a larger hole. Okay, and then once I had that hole drilled, then I took a triangular file. Hopefully you can see that in the video camera. I laid this on here, this triangle file. I laid the point straight down towards one of these points. And I filed it to a point there. And I did that on all four corners, and then I flattened it out in between. Okay, to get the square hole. Now, how do we use this? All right, glad you asked. Okay, here is a drill bit. This is how I carry my drill bit in a little short length of PVC pipe. All right, now's a good time to explain that this drill bit is too small. It's the largest that I had here at home. It's a 9/16, and it's working, but a 1 inch would be much better. Unfortunately, my larger bits are out at our cabin, our remote cabin. We won't be able to get out there until after the rivers freeze up this winter. And then I'll bring that back with me, a 1 inch. Okay, this is an Irwin bit. You can see that it's got screw threads on this. Once these bite in, they help to pull the bit into the wood. Okay, this is a bit for a brace, a hand brace, the kind that you put your hand on top of, and then you take your other hand and you operate the brace like this, for bracing bits. Okay, now, as you can see, this has got a wedge-shaped square end that goes right in here, like that. Okay, so now all we have to do is cut a stick when we're out in the field. And I got one right here. Right there. So now we've got a working bit driver. Okay, works every bit as good as the expensive Scotch Eyed Augers. All right. Now, let's take a look at some furniture I made here, and we'll continue to work on a piece until we got it finished up. Okay, here's a little stool that I was working on right here. I made this one three-legged. The reason for that is the ground is often uneven in a camp type setting, and four legs, invariably there will be a leg that's up in the air and you'll be rocking back and forth. But on a three-legged stool, all three legs are always on the ground. Okay, now here's a little short four-legged stool that I made. As I said, the bit I'm using is 9/16, so I've got some pretty skinny legs here. But nevertheless, it's still quite sturdy. All right. Let me show you how to use the bit and the driver. Okay, I'm in my yard, so you'll hear traffic. You'll hear traffic out on the highway. Because I do have neighbors here. All right, now let's show you how this works. Okay, since this is so narrow, 9/16, I can do a lot of this just hand turning this. Okay, the screws are biting in and now we're starting to cut in. As you can see, it's peeling up the wood from where the hole is located. Okay, I'm trying to keep this straight. Straight up and down in relation to this board. Okay. So I'll come back when I've got this all drilled out. Okay, I think that's probably deep enough. So let's back that out. All right. Now, a tool that I have found that is very handy for this step is my little pocket bellows that I made from a hot dog cooker. What makes this so handy is I can stick it down in the hole and blast out the debris that's in the hole. Okay, now, now what we need to do is we need to carve our little sticks that we're going to put in here. So let's do that. Okay, I think we about got it. So we'll taper the very end here a little bit and give this a try. Okay. Sounds like that's seated pretty good. Now, see if this is gonna fit. Okay, let's give that a try. Look at there. Fits really well, works really good. Okay, as I was saying, your imagination is the limit. As you can see, chairs are pretty easy to make. You can make tables. You could make cots. You could even make bunks, you know, double tier bunks. Whatever you could think up. This little handy tool is pretty useful around the camp. And it just doesn't take up hardly any room. Okay, well, thanks for joining me. And we'll see you folks on the next video. You guys have a good week. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.